Hello, everyone. I'm WDSU sports anchor Fletcher Mackel. And Saints linebacker DeMario Davis said the words. He said the Saints' 38-3 victory over the Green Bay Packers here in Jacksonville, Florida, was a statement victory. And the biggest statement came from quarterback Jameis Winston, the third-string QB for the New Orleans Saints after the Tampa Bay Buccaneers chose not to re-sign him in 2020. Jameis is now QB1 for the black and gold. He started his Saints career by throwing 5 touchdowns. Down passes, but more impressive, his decision-making. Realized that turnovers were a huge problem for Jameis Winston when he was with the Buccaneers. On Sunday, he didn't throw bad passes. He just tucked it and ran, and that was a good thing, something that he says he learned from Drew Brees.
Drew always preached, it's about the decision, not the result, right? Sometimes the decision is throwing a ball away. Sometimes the decision is running, tugging. Sometimes the decision may be taking a sack. So the more that we keep making the right decision, it'll take care of itself.
Those were big plays. I mean, they ultimately helped us with the first field goal. I thought he played very well. He was locked in, focused. You know, we spread the ball around and you know, we're going to go through that tape and we're going to look at, you know, some of the throws, and there might be a progression or two, but I thought he played very well.
2 of Jameis Winston's 5 touchdown passes went to second-year player Juwan Johnson. He came to the black and gold as an undrafted player out of Oregon as a wide receiver. He has since bulked up, and he is now a tight end, playing a key role in the offense.
Last year when I got cut and I was on practice squad, I feel like I told you guys before, I just hated that feeling sitting and watching, you know, the team play, and I feel like I couldn't contribute. Because I've always been a guy that I just always wanted to just be out there and contribute. I don't care about stats, I don't care about catches, just like the win. I love the win. And so when I couldn't do that, I had no control over it. It cut me deep. So this offseason, I really grinded hard. Like, I grinded really hard. So, you know, really coming out here and them having trust in me and them, you know, valuing me and giving me the ball and having me allow me to make plays and be on special teams, it's a blessing, man. Like, this is something that, you know, I prayed for in the offseason. Now I'm finally seeing it during the season.
Defensively, the Saints front 7 was fantastic. In the secondary, they really shined, picking off reigning league MVP Aaron Rodgers twice. Rodgers even targeted rookie third-round draft pick Paulson Adebo several times, but the youngster out of Stanford answered the bell each and every time.
You know, you get 1 or 2 plays, and you're like, okay, I can play with these guys. And then from then on, you know, it's just glorified practice. Obviously, coming into every game, you know, in my mind, I'm thinking, oh, I'm going to get a pick, but to actually have it, and then especially, you know, the quarterback that it was, all-time great, definitely cool.
I think he came in with a lot of confidence, and he plays with that swagger that he knows he could do. So he comes in, he's playing, he's balling, he doesn't care who he lines up against, and you can see it on the field. You see him blocking up number 17. He may have got a flag, but we don't know if that really was a flag, but he's doing his job as a rookie coming in.
Because of the recovery from Hurricane Ida, the New Orleans Saints will now travel back to Fort Worth, Texas. They're, of course, practicing on the campus of TCU. The Black and Gold's next game on the road in Charlotte against the Carolina Panthers. Reporting in Jacksonville, I'm Fletcher Mackel, WDSU News.